may have leaked from a Wuhan lab.
This as the president calls on intel officials to get to the bottom of the origins of the virus. Florida Congresswoman Kat Kamick joins us now to react. Congresswoman, thanks so much for being here. Look, we're not breaking any news today by saying we know the mainstream media hated Donald J. Trump, but how much of an indictment is that admission by Jonathan Karl right there?
You know, I think it's pretty incredible that we've even gotten to this point when the media and this current administration has such a disdain for our former president, President Trump, and they're willing to bend the truth to really fit the narrative that they're pushing. That says a lot about the current state of affairs. But listen, as a member of the Homeland Security Committee, I can tell you that we are committed to finding out the truth. And I think every American, regardless if you're Republican or Democrat, you would want to know exactly what the origins of this virus was. It's the only way that we can actually move forward and be better prepared for the inevitable next pandemic or the inevitable next attack. And the fact that the media was so quick to dismiss this just because the Trump administration was investigating the origins and had suggested and actually had evidence that pointed back to that Wuhan lab, that's pretty disgusting. So I think there's a whole lot of crow that they have to eat at this point. And again, it feeds right into this narrative that Americans have been understanding for some time now, is that the fake news is out there because they are so quick to push their own narrative rather than the facts.
One of the things I've always taken pride in is being impartial and giving people the facts and letting them do what they want and you know, decide for themselves on things. And I think that this is really a gut check at this time in history with a lot in the media, because the media shouldn't be shaping these narratives. The media should be offering the information as it stands. And that was not the situation from day one with this pandemic, especially when you're talking about different theories on how this potentially leaked. The media shouldn't decide that.
Absolutely. There was a political agenda from the word go, from the beginnings when there was a cover up in China with the WHO basically towing the CCP line, promoting that they were doing all they could for containment. They were manipulating data, which, of course, we know was extremely detrimental, because in the early stages of a pandemic, that early data modeling is critical so that other countries and other entities can be better prepared in combating a virus. But as we saw, the WHO was complicit in that. And so when we pulled out of the WHO, and believe me, as much taxpayer dollars that went into the WHO, we expected, and Americans and really the world deserved better from the World Health Organization. But we were quick to see the political agenda that was being pushed at the highest level of the WHO, in that we're complicit with the CCP in this. But again, you look at everything that has been done. Masks have become political. The vaccines have become political. Everything that should be nonpartisan, that should be based and rooted in science and fact, has actually turned into a political agenda by the ultra-liberal left. And they're doing this simply because they don't want President Trump to be right. And that is a fact. So now we have to go back and look at all of the different opportunities that the left had to manipulate the facts, the data, the science, and really get to the root cause of it. And again, I know that my colleagues and I are hell-bent on doing just that.
We're about to wrap up the show here, so 30 seconds on the back end for your answer. Yeah. U.S. troop withdrawal from Afghanistan slightly ahead of schedule. Should we be worried, though, about a resurgence of the Taliban in the coming months?
You know, listen, the first thing that we're taught at the United States Naval War College is you have got to have a war termination plan and a strategy. And we all know that nature abhors a vacuum. As we pull out of Afghanistan, which it's long past time that we do that, but I think we've discovered that war and the counterinsurgency, counterterrorism, and conventional tactics just don't work. And so Al-Qaeda is definitely gaining ground back. I think the important thing right now is not to leave our allies hanging.